So in this video, we're going to factor trinomials using what's called the AC method. So let's say, for example, that you wanted to factor. Let's say that you had the trinomial about 2x squared minus 5x minus 3. How would you factor that? So first of all, this is what we call a quadratic trinomial. It's a quadratic trinomial. So we call it a trinomial because there are three terms, and we call it quadratic because it's of second degree. So we're going to use a method called the AC method that's going to allow us to factor this systematically. Now, we're going to just start off with an observation. So let's go ahead and observe. If you had 3x squared plus 4x plus 5x minus 2, most of the time, so far in algebra, we're used to combining like terms. So most of the time, we're used to taking the 4x and the 5x and adding those together and getting, well, 3x squared plus 9x minus 2. The first observation that we want to make is that sometimes, and right now we just want to observe that it's possible, sometimes you actually want to take that 3x squared plus 9x minus 2 and you want to do the reverse of what I just did here. That is, instead of combining the 4x and the 5x to get 9x, sometimes you actually want to split the 9x. So the 3x squared will remain the same, and the 9x you might be able to write as, well, 4x plus 5x minus 2. Now that's kind of strange, right? It's clear, you know, we had a use for combining like terms, but why would you ever want to take something and split it up? It seems like you've made something more complicated. Well, it turns out that this is going to be part of the AC method. And for right now, all we want to observe is that it's possible to do so. Now, it's not clear exactly how to do it, because after all, there are infinite combinations, right? It could have been, well, here it was 4x and 5x, but it could have been 3x and 6x, or 2x and 7x, or 1x and 8x. It's not clear right now how I got the 4x and the 5x, but the AC method will make that clear. Okay, so the types of trinomials generally that we're going to be factoring right now are of the following form: ax squared plus bx plus c. Now the a, b, and the c are just numbers. Well, we call them coefficients, but remember, they're just numbers. And you want to make sure in this method that you actually identify what your A, B, and your C are. Okay? So let's go ahead and illustrate the AC method. Let's go ahead and factor. How about we have 6x squared plus 7x minus 5. So the first thing we're going to do is identify our A, B, and our C. I can see by comparison that the a is 6, the b is 7, and the c is negative 5. Let's write that off to the side here. That a is equal to 6, b is equal to 7, and c is equal to negative 5. Okay, so the first step of the AC method is to multiply the a and the c together. In this case, I'm going to get the number negative 30, and I'm going to write that right here off to the side. So that number that you get, that is A multiplied by C. And that's why we call this the AC method, to remind us that multiplying A and C together, that's the first thing we do. That's our first step. Okay, so now that once you have that number, what you do is you think of possible factorizations of it. And we're going to do this systematically. So for example, well, this is a negative number, so I know that I need one negative and one positive to get a negative upon multiplying. So one possibility is negative 1 times positive 30. So this is a factorization of negative 30. Are there others? Absolutely. Negative 2 times 15, they multiply to be negative 30. And same with negative 3 times 10. Now 4 doesn't go into 30, but 5 does. Negative 5 times 6. And I could continue in this fashion, right? The next factorization could be negative 6 times 5 and negative 10 times 3. Now it turns out that I already have what I need for the following reason. The next step in the AC method is to ask yourself, do any of these factorizations, do any pair of numbers add to be the B? Well, the B here is 7. So when I look at these factorizations, well, these two numbers add to be 29, these two add to be 13, and negative 3 plus 10, they indeed add to be positive 7. And once you identify that, you circle that pair of numbers. And you make a note that in this case, they add to our B, which in this case is positive 7. And the reason that's significant is because if these numbers add to be positive 7, then surely I can write this 7 as negative 3 plus 10. That is, I can use this combination of numbers to split up that positive 7. So the 6x squared remains the same, but as we just said, negative 3 plus 10, that is positive 7. So I can write the 7x as negative 3x plus 10x minus 5. Okay, so now when I'm looking at this, I say to myself, well, I had 3 terms and now I have 4. And when I have 4 terms, I think about factoring by grouping. And the way that works is, well, we group the first 2 terms and the last 2 terms. And I ask myself, well, what do they have in common? Just these first 2. Well, the GCF of these 2 terms is 3x. And I factor that out. So I have 3x times, well, let's see, 2x minus 1. And now I go on to the next pair. What do 10x and 5 have in common? That would be a positive 5. And I factor that out. So I have 5 times 2x minus 1. Now at this stage, I don't yet have a product because I still have addition in the middle. But notice that this term and this term have something in common. Do you see how they have the 2x minus 1 in common? Because they do, you factor it out of both of them, and you get 2x minus 1 multiplied by what remains, which is 3x plus 5. Okay? And at this stage, we've managed to take the quadratic trinomial 6x squared plus 7x minus 5 and write it as the product of two binomials, 2x minus 1 times 3x plus 5. So the way to recap, the way the AC method works is you identify your A, B, and your C, you multiply A and C together, and then you find the factorizations of that number. You look for a factorization where the two numbers add to be your B. You use them to split up the B, like I did here, and then you factor by grouping. And what they have in common at this stage, you factor that out, and you're left with a product. And that's how the AC method works.